Hello everyone, welcome to Reach Goals. Today I'm going to talk about how to distribute the cache and about consistent hashing with real-world example. So we have an initial requirement. In that we have a file which is of very large size, which has 1 billion lines. And in that we know we have a content like key and value. The key is an integer and the value is an IP address, right? So now our requirement is like, you know, we have to take this file and distribute across multiple caches so that we can read it very easily, right? So in this, since it's a large file, we cannot put in one machine. We are going to put in four different machines, right? So the machine 0 will have the records from 1 to 250 millionth line, and machine 5 will have the records from 251 million to 500 million, and machine 7 will have 501 to 750 million, and machine 10 will have 751 to 1 billion record, right? So now if we have the content distributed like this, our load balancer or the client can access the different machines and it can get the content very easily, right? So now the load is equally distributed, right? So we can also have an algorithm in the load balancer to connect different machines based on our need, correct? That is a configurable thing, or you can have an algorithm in a load balancer based on your need, right? In this, we have configured in such a way it connects to the four different machines, right? After some point of time, our requirement slightly changes. Let's see what the change. So we noticed the load on the machine 7 is too high, right? So the number of requests coming to the machine 7 is too high. So we want to add one more machine, which is machine 6. You can see in the screen, machine 6 is a new machine. Now what happens here is our load balancer is already configured to connect only to four different machines. And now if he wants to connect to fifth machine, the data in the machines has to be equally distributed, or it has to be equally shared, right? So now when we have a new machine, the load balancer, even though it connects to the new machine, it will not have a content. So we have to redistribute the key values or the content which are in the cache servers, right? So how it happens over here is, if you look into the screen, only the change happens in the machine 6 and machine 7. It is not happening across all the machines, right? So that is what we call it as a consistent hashing, right? So in the consistent hashing, what actually happens is we don't want to change all the keys or all the values in different cache servers, and it is only changed to specific servers where there is a minimum impact. There is this little bit of formula over that, and you can see that in the next screen, correct? So here is a definition of consistent hashing. If you look into the red color, what it says is when a hash table is resized and the consistent hashing is used, only k by n keys needs to be remapped on average, where k is the number of keys and n is the number of slots. That's what we did in the previous screen. Like, you know, when the machine 7 or machine 6 has been added, the change has happened only in the machine 6 and machine 7, not across all the machines, right? So that is what how we apply the consistent hashing for a distributed cache, or when we want to have a distributed load, correct? And the concept of consistent hashing is used in across multiple companies, like, you know, Netflix, it is used in Facebook, it is used in Akamai, etc., right? Let's talk about a real world example considering the Netflix, right? So you have n number of machines connecting to the load balancers, and load balancers in turn connect to the different machines, right? So each machine has its own movies, and they would be having the movie ID as 1 to 250 in machine 0 and 251 to 500 in machine 5 and 501 to 750 in machine 7 and 751 to 1000 in machine 10, right? So the now all the load is distributed across the globe and people are watching the movie very happily without any buffer, right? All of the sudden you came to know that the machine 7 is getting heavily loaded. Like, you know, machine 7 might be having a popular movie, right? At one point of time, a lot of people want to see the same movie, and all the hits will go into the machine 7, which has the movies which are very popular, maybe the number ranging from 501 to 750 now, right? So now what we have to do is we have to add one more machine, right? So now I will add one more machine. Look into the green color, which is connecting to the other machine, which is machine 6, right? So if you have a new machine, the content in the machine 7 has to be equally distributed, or it has to be distributed into the other machine, which is machine 6, right? So now if you see the movie ID ranging from 501 to 600 goes into the machine 6, and the machine 7 will have the movie ID from 601 to 750, right? So here there is a challenge, right? So earlier we have configured our load balancer to connect to four different machines, right? Now we have 5 different machines, and the load balancer has to be reconfigured to connect into 5 different machines, right? So when the load balancer is connecting into the new machine, it will not have a content, right? Before it gets connected, the content has to be equally distributed, right? So in this kind of a model, what we are doing is we don't want to add or we don't want to redistribute the load across all the machines. Instead, we are redistributing the load only between the machine 6 and 7, right? This is a concept where we are calling it as a consistent hashing, right? So we can treat this as a ring, correct? Machine 1 to 10 can be connected as a ring, and you can see that as a circle visually, right? That is what they call it as a consistent hash ring, right? So this is a very popular concept which is used in all the load balancers, or when you want to have a distributed cache, or when we want to distribute the content across the globe with a minimum impact to the existing machines, then we call it as a mechanism where we use it to have a consistent load balancing, right? That's it I have. Thanks for watching.